cuts in health care need not have been made. There were choices, budget choices, that the legislature made instead of making some other choices. The year after, session after the budget, the health care cuts were made, the legislature gave huge, huge economic development subsidies to a very few people. For example, they gave one land developer in St. Louis a $95 million tax credit. Now, I would use that money to restore health care cuts to kids. If you ask me to choose between one big contributing land developer who happens to be represented by the governor's brother, and or 70,000 kids who are off of health care, I'll pick the 70,000 kids every single time. There is money to restore people to health care. All we have to do is make the right decisions. And it's not easy. I served on every single budget conference for 10 years. I think that no one else in the history of the state of Missouri ever did that for 10 years running. That's over 200 conference committees. So I understand the budget process. I was chairman for 3 years. Those health care cuts need not have been made, and they need not have been made in the cruel way that they did. Here's what they did. They allowed people to have wheelchairs, but not wheelchair batteries. They allowed people to have oxygen, but not the device that regulates the oxygen. Those kinds of things are reprehensible and wrong. The choices that were made should have taken care of those kids before they took care of the governor's brother's buttons.
Would anyone like a response?
I'd like to add to that.
All right. You have 2 minutes, Mrs. Stone.